G'day, panel. My question is in regards to CO2 in the atmosphere. I have conversations with friends of mine about climate change and global warming, and one of the questions that has come up is how CO2 in the atmosphere allows heat from the sun through whilst also trapping heat in, creating the warming effect. Could someone explain the science behind that, please?
OK, Dave, we'll go back to you, obviously.
Sure. Look, the answer is relatively easy. I mean, carbon dioxide is a visibly transparent gas. In other words, it allows sunlight to pass through. But infrared radiation, or long wavelength radiation, is absorbed by carbon dioxide and many, many other greenhouse gases, which absorb the infrared radiation and then re-emit that both vertically upwards but also back down to the surface. That infrared radiation is basically heat radiation that's emitted by the surface of the Earth upwards. When we have much lower concentrations of greenhouse gases, that infrared radiation will penetrate through the atmosphere and go up to space. And we're currently at much, much higher concentrations, not only of carbon dioxide, but many other long-lived greenhouse gases, including methane, nitrous oxide, chlorofluorocarbons, and their increases in the atmosphere over the last 100 years have been primarily due to human activity.
Now, David, scientists sometimes, quite often, in fact, change their mind due to experimentation. I'll take you back to 1986, 33 years ago, because you were sceptical then about human-induced global warming and you began a series of experiments. What happened?
Well, what I was doing was not so much doing experiments as analysing new data collected from all around the Earth. And this was... I was trying to be CSI, but this isn't crime scene investigators. This is climate scientists investigating.
Yeah.
And so what I was doing was saying, look, I'm going to look for fingerprints, the spatial patterns of temperature change that would be due to increases in carbon dioxide in the atmosphere that would be different from the spatial fingerprints in the vertical structures of the atmosphere, say due to increasing strength of the sun. Because there's a range of commentators who say, well, actually the warming we've seen is just due to a hotter sun. What we know is that if the sun is getting stronger, it would certainly warm up the surface, but it would also warm up the upper atmosphere where ultraviolet radiation and sunlight is absorbed by ozone and oxygen. But the influence of carbon dioxide is to warm up the lower atmosphere, but actually to lead to a cooling of the upper atmosphere. And I looked for that fingerprint in temperature data from across the weather stations in the southern hemisphere, and then separately did it for the northern hemisphere. And what I found was the more we looked, the stronger was the evidence. And that became, in fact, seen as a fingerprint that could distinguish between climate change due to greenhouse gases and climate change due to any other cause, natural variability, sunlight from the sun, climate change due to an absence of volcanoes. All of those could lead to warming of the surface. But what we found was there's convincing evidence. And that led to a conclusion 10 years later. So my first research papers on climate change were published in 1987 and 1988, first looking at the southern hemisphere and then looking at the northern hemisphere profiles of this. And we found, even then, 30 years ago, more than 90% confidence that human emissions of greenhouse gases were causing that warming as observed.
Okay.
Over the last...